Hello, and I hope this finds you well. Welcome to this very special webinar on how to benefit from our awards in Bath, Bristol, Cardiff or Exeter. They're the biggest business event in each city, and it's just a lovely time of year. Here we are in the run-up to Christmas, and we're thinking about the celebration of all that's absolutely best about our cities. My name is Greg, co-founder of Media Clash, which runs these awards, and here's our MD, Steph.
Hi, and thanks for joining us today. Please send us your questions via the Q&A button below throughout if you have any. You can do that anonymously or put your name on it and we'll cover as many as possible. This webinar is being recorded and will be on our YouTube channel shortly as well. It'll also be promoted on our social feeds and will be on our awards site so that everyone can see what's best to do for their nominations and the commercial options.
Yeah, so we'll be talking about how you can benefit from these important business celebrations in Bath, Bristol, Cardiff and Exeter. Short version, multiple ways, basically. And also, of course, how you might win, how you craft the best nomination. Meantime, just take a look at this. It is simply joyous. Yeah, so if you're familiar with our awards, you'll get a transported back moment to those days of February, March and years gone by where we celebrate the whole of the city, all sectors, all types, from commercial to charity and civic, from new companies to long established, from the smallest of the indies to the largest of the corporates, everyone coming together to celebrate the very best of their city. Thank you for your support in the past over many years now and prospectively for 2024.
Okay, let's do this. We're going to be talking about today how to benefit from these awards. First of all, the nominations. The awards are free to enter. We'll be giving you all the top tips on marshalling your case to stand the best chance of being a finalist and perhaps a winner. Very much focused on what the judges are looking for. Also, all the benefits of becoming a finalist and a winner. Commercially, we'll talk you through the different ways you can benefit from major citywide multi-channel marketing campaigns before, during and after the awards, and of course, how to benefit on the night. There'll also be some helpful comments from sponsors about how their businesses benefit from the awards. As well as nominations and sponsorship, we'll also cover every aspect of the awards. We'll talk you through the marketing, the categories. There are some changes for 2024, so we'll talk you through those shortly. Also the judges, what to expect on the night, and all the key dates and information. So why do awards matter? Good question. There's five main reasons. First of all, unrivaled credibility. These awards are the leading, most credible, most anticipated and sought after in their cities, and therefore the most valuable, whether for winners or sponsors. The greatest scale from across the cities, huge numbers of companies nominate, record numbers in recent years. Nearly 2,000 people attend the four awards. Check out the companies involved tabs on each of the websites for more. There's also huge multiple channel marketing before, during and after the awards, editorial and advertising in the city leading magazines, unrivaled email marketing, and the city's biggest reach on social media across X, LinkedIn and Instagram. Social does go off the scale on awards day and awards night and the morning after. And we'll discuss more details of the marketing shortly. The awards are also a powerful business driver. Relationships are built and extended at the awards and the exclusive receptions, and business is done.
Yeah, there's another benefit as well, sort of lurking perhaps a little bit beneath the surface. It's one of the deeper enduring benefits of these awards is peer recognition. As business owners, bosses, managers, teams, how is your success recognized? Where do you get validation? Sales and profit, of course, essential. New wins, great projects, happy clients, many direct aspects of business. But sometimes, just sometimes, public recognition really helps. Imagine gaining the validation of your peers, your work, your company, discussed, highlighted, shortlisted, and of course, some chosen as winners by independent experts. And that's one of the reasons why awards matter. It's that public recognition. As finalists or possibly winners, it's rare when people other than your own teams and customers recognize the quality of what you do. So in summary, the awards are, they're great for teams, they're valuable to recognize a contribution, and great for business. Recognition, validation, marketing opportunities, deeper relationship with clients and customers, new business development. And we'll talk you through now some of the marketing benefits of being involved with the awards.
Yeah, so whether for nominating or for commercial benefit, these awards are backed by a massive marketing campaign benefiting finalists, sponsors and winners. Before the awards, we promote for months throughout our channels, dozens of pages of advertising and editorial in the city's leading magazines, each with 10,000 copies, each with untold more readers. Thousands of opportunities to see on multiple emails to over 14,000 businesses and a further 13,000 consumers. A combined social media and email reach of over 300,000 on X, LinkedIn and Instagram, all channels multiple times. And with this high profile, it's great if you win, great if you sponsor. Also, before the awards, all of our finalists and sponsors are invited to an exclusive free reception in each city. The receptions are fun occasions in themselves and a few weeks ahead of the awards with all the finalists and sponsors, in all around 150 people in each city. But they're also highly valuable exclusive business networking with other leading companies in a lovely setting. Once again, business starts with a conversation. During the awards evening, there's repeated prominence as well. You get prominent profiles in the show guides, the sponsor showreels, on stage and on screen, and the grip and grin boards for the winners' photos, which are then shared multiple times on social. Then after the awards, there's even more coverage in the magazines, on the marketing emails, on the websites, and on the social channels. So in aggregate, there's tens of thousands of opportunities to see sponsor brands in each of the awards. There's great presence for finalists and a huge profile boost for winners. There's also free marketing assets for all finalists, highly commended and category winners. Physical assets for windows and offices, digital assets for social, email footers and websites. Think of it as bronze, silver and gold winners.
Yeah, and by the way, please do pop any questions through and we'll try and take them. I mean, it's in our interest for you to get the most out of these awards, to craft your nominations in the most appealing way, but also to explore the commercial opportunities as well. We mentioned this phrase, distinctive and specific, about the physical awards themselves. But this is what the awards look like: weighty, distinctive, really worth winning and displaying, whether it's a boardroom or a shop or a restaurant or just your own private office. They are magical things in their own right. Carefully designed and crafted to reflect each of the cities. So Bath is made from Bath stone. You can imagine the brainstorm that resulted in that as a conclusion. Cardiff is hewn from Welsh slate. Exeter is mirroring the cathedral. And for Bristol, take a look at this. We love this video. Look at this one. Find that hypnotic. You can see that it's burnished in a forge, proudly reflecting, in this case, the Clifton Suspension Bridge, carefully wrought by artisans and highly distinctive.
So let's come on to some of the categories, judging criteria and top tips. Excuse me. to improve your chances of winning these awards. You'll see that we'll cover all areas of business and cultural life in the cities, and it's free to nominate. You can enter as many categories as apply to your company. You can add a paragraph or two on any additional categories or do a fresh application. Do note the sustainability category. Any business can demonstrate that it's acting in a more sustainable way. And please also note that Welsh language is only in the Cardiff Life Awards, of course. The overall creme de la creme individual best category is chosen by the judges as the platinum winner each time. So new for 2024, companies always say that their biggest asset is their people. So we're very pleased to be able to include a special new employer category for next year in all categories, which will be much prized. And in Bath, there's also the new category of luxury, and any aspect of luxury living, luxury business, hotels, spas, jewelers, bespoke products, concierge property services, and more could apply for this one.
Yeah, so we come on now to all aspects of the nominations and judging process, plus some helpful tips reflecting the criteria by which the judges are making their decisions. Excuse me. It is winter after all. Who would we be without coughs this time of year? Let's come on to our independent judges. We begin with the judges, since their approach is absolutely vital to how you should approach your nominations. The awards are decided by a panel of independent judges chosen afresh
each year from all areas of business and civic life in the cities. It's a really thorough process.
Very good. It's also a joint effort as well. Yeah, it's, it is a thorough process.
You can just ask a former judge. They're groups of great probity wanting to make sure that they're collectively come to the best decisions based on the shortlisted nominations that they receive.
Yeah, thanks. And here are the all important judging criteria.
They're on the site and also on the nomination forms. Just consider what it's like being a judge when you're writing your nomination. If you're shortlisted, obviously they will read and discuss your own fine nomination, but there are dozens of other very fine nominations.
Here we are, you see, it's the nature of live events that things like losing your voice happen. So this truly is live. We'd re-record it if it weren't. Anyway, to have a look at this, the most important part is the, the year's performance. It's worth 50% of the judge's assessment. So let's give a couple of tips about how to craft these categories, these nominations. It's really important that you demonstrate what successes look like rather than just saying it.
The key thing by far is quantify your success. Give examples and proof of how this year has been strong for you, whether sales, new businesses, new people, products, services, outlets, offerings. How exactly did you and your team develop? What external recognition have you had, and what are you most proud of?
We also want to reflect the longer term success that many companies have had, of course. So there's 15% of the judges' marks go to this about the success and impact. Many sizable businesses have had demonstrable success over years. So please highlight some of your key developments. It is, as I say, you can see here, worth 15%.
I'm also worth 15% is the civic value. So what do you do for the city beyond your normal core business offering, and what are your values? Civic values matter increasingly, both fundamentally to the city and also to the perception of your company. So have a think about, how do you connect with your city? What do you do to play your part? What are your values as a company, outwardly and inwardly with your teams? What do you do ecologically, or maybe in terms of diversity? Tell the judges and it'll really help you stand out. Also for 15% is the quality of the nomination. Take your time on this, marshal your case. There's the option for additional material, full size of A4, and by all means add testimonials, which are worth another 5%. Judges are always keen to see the effort put into nominations and that you've presented your case clearly, whether with stats or passion or both. And in your closing pitch, sum up in a nutshell why you should win. What's the killer reason? Give the judges a really helpful summary at the end and add fresh points if useful, some ammo that they can use to help argue their case in favour of your nomination if they need it. Think of it as, in addition to the points above, we've also done XXX. The closing pitch is what Hollywood calls the elevator pitch. Lasts as long as a ride in a lift. Go.
Just on that, actually, it's notable in the judging sessions that judges can be back and forth, and one of them says, hang on a second, look at this, and we'll highlight that closing pitch. Just prior, Steph, before we come on to the next piece, we've had couple of questions for our good friend, anonymous attendee. If I'm a sponsor, can I nominate? Absolutely so. The nominations are open to any company, whatever size, whether you're a sponsor or a previous winner, multiple categories and so on. And likewise, it may well be the same person, don't know. Can I enter multiple categories? Yes, and we'll explain a little bit more about that, but please do put yourself forward. For example, you may be an absolutely brilliant legal firm, and you also may wish to enter the employer category. You might be business services and wish to be in sustainability. And it says, how many testimonials can be included? I think our maximum is it 3 or 5? It's on the nomination form. We try to keep it.
It's a word count.
Mm. We try to keep it relatively short. Bear in mind, it's worth 5%. It's something. It's maybe not the decider. It's definitely worth including because it gives an idea of the support you have from your clients or your customers. Yeah.
I would also say as well, when you're entering multiple categories, make sure that you, if there's something that you need to write specifically about that category, then include it. And we do provide a space for you to do that on the nomination form. There's a separate question that says, if you're entering multiple categories, put more info here. If you're not doing completely separate nominations for each category, as much additional ammo as you can put in for those extra categories will be worth it, because you'll be up against other finalists that have purely entered that category alone. Just when you're going through your nomination, just check back, what are the judges judging? Just have a look at the criteria, that it's there on the nomination form as well, so you can see it whilst you're doing your entry. If you're entering more than one category, why not? You can, it's free, so just do as many as you can, and like I said, explain why you're entering each, don't just tick the box. And if you have specific information, then it may help you to create separate nominations. So use the real estate of the nomination forms wisely. You can give such useful information for judges in just a few hundred words, and give them the ammo to say, I think X should win because, as Greg just mentioned.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Yeah, good luck to all. We really do appreciate the time and effort that people spend on nominations. Quite a few have said to us, by the way, that it's actually a useful pause, particularly over that Christmas, early New Year period, where you reflect on what's been achieved and you think, actually, we have had a great year, or our team is brilliant, or we've won these new clients, or whatever it is. So yes, very much good luck. A few more points about our judges. They meet on judging day to discuss the finalist nominations in great detail. The decisions are wholly collective. It's the sort of wisdom of crowds approach. And if there are any conflicts of interest, they stand aside from that category and don't even know the result of that category until awards night itself. We give detailed notes about process, not about the decision making, and clear criteria on how to approach the analysis and decisions. And these notes are available for all to see on the websites. Judges are drawn from diverse areas. Have a look at these. This is just a few examples. You'll recognise some larger scale national, even international businesses, some locally grown independents, some mid-tier regionals. It might be hospitality, it might be professional services. Come on to the next slide, you'll get a sense that the aim is to have a combination by size and company of all sectors reflecting the city back to itself. And you'll see several familiar names here, each playing a part in the city. We also seek to try to balance the genders and to reflect the diversity within the cities of all different sorts. Some of the judges we'll know before, others we won't. It doesn't matter. All are entrusted with the vital decisions, which feeds into the award processes early next year. Let's come on, should we to the commercial opportunities?
Yeah, it looks like we've maybe had a couple more questions.
Okay,
actually,
let's
as well.
Take that.
Let's have a look at those.
Loads more. Wow. Yeah. How is the judging panel picked, and what about a competitor judging my nomination? Let's just check we've got all of this. It's an open process, and so in terms of judging, how we work is sometimes it's inbound, it's nearly always outbound. We're trying to get a balance of different, as mentioned, sizes of businesses, sectors, ethnicities, gender, experience in a city, etc. So it's not science, it's very much a sort of an art of what is possible, but we love the way our judges take it so seriously and step up to the plate each time. In terms of competitors judging, that is the nature of competitions. There will be judgments made, but think of it this way. You may have one competitor on a panel, but there are 7, 8, 9 other judges, and it's always the wisdom of crowds. And judges, they're smart people. They can spot if someone's saying, "Ooh, I really don't think they're any," when they are palpably brilliant. We have often had apparently competitive companies win, and it may well be the judges having that sense of responsibility across the piece who are the most articulate in favour, even though someone may well be competitive. It doesn't, the competitive thing doesn't happen too much, and I'd suggest you know, maybe don't get too focused on that, but the process is thorough, open, transparent and fair.
And if there's if there is a real conflict, then judges are recused as well. So during the judging day, if their company or a company that they're close to is being discussed, we will actually we do the judging sessions on Zoom now. We pop them in the waiting room, so they're not actually part of that discussion. And the remainder of the judges make the decisions, and they actually don't find out then until the actual event who the winner is.
Till subsequently. And Ivana S. has said, will this be shared with us after the meeting? Very much. We'll be on our YouTube channels. We will then promote that through our social channels and email. And we'll also slice and dice this video so you can see parts of it. A specific question from Sue Serrett. She works for a particular charity. I want to ask how, In Focus Charity, I want to ask how you choose your charity judges. Well, Sue, we don't choose charity judges per se. The charities, like all categories, are judged by the same panel of judges using the same type of criteria. And just one thing I would say about charities, there's no hierarchy. There's no sort of some charities quote better than another or is doing more valuable work. They are all even in that respect, and the judges have to decide how well have they played their hand. They're seeking to do this, what have they done during the year? And we're very, very cautious in both charities and in all of the categories that somehow bigger doesn't beat smaller, or alternatively, smaller isn't cooler than bigger. It's not that at all. We've had majors win, we've had very, very early stage startups win in all different forms. It is, I hope, a fair process. Do you have a word limit for the entry? Yes, we do. If you look at the nominations forms, we'll come on to the timing of those shortly. There are precise word limits, the max, but you run up to those limits, use that limit. If you have multiple sites across Bristol, can you enter as a group or a single site? Not quite knowing what your offering is, Mr. or Mrs. Ums, anonymous attendee, you should put the company forward and talk about the particular iterations of where you've got outlets. If it's, I don't know, it might be a cafe or restaurant, I'm not sure. But it should be, ideally should be the company, unless they trade as wholly separate businesses and you want to foreground a particular trading entity. You'll know your business better than we might do in theory. Coming into multiple categories, yes, we stress that. What is the criteria for the new business category? How long is long enough and how long is too long in regards to trading? Good question. So it's any business which has started no earlier than July 1st of 2022. In other words, 18 months worth of trading. So if you have started in the spring of 22, you wouldn't be valid for it, but any time after that you are. Clearly, if you've started in the last 6 weeks, you know, it's gonna be hard to win, but we have had wins from companies that started in November, right at the very end of the year. Make your case. Alex Sava makes a similar point about, will the video be available? Absolutely, we want to be as transparent as possible. Abby Oldfield, who asked an earlier question, we have lots of fundraising events going on over Christmas. Are we allowed to speak on this, or should we focus on how the work has already been done in 2023? Good question, and it applies to all different sorts. The period covered is calendar 2023, so I mean right up to the end of, you know, December 31st. Reference it, you can write your nomination in January, anything that's happened in that 12-month period. Is there a distance limit to enter, says anonymous attendee. As a rough rule of thumb, we suggest a 25-mile radius of the city. This isn't like school, you know, zones or whatever. So, you know, if in doubt, ask us. The one difference would be Bath and Bristol, which are clearly much less than 25 miles apart from each other. If you're fundamentally Bristol-facing business, guess what? Please enter Bristol, and then conversely, Bath. We don't think it's fair to enter. You know, Bath isn't to enter Bristol. I
mean, lots of questions.
Yeah, lots of questions.
Great,
yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, please keep them coming in. By the way, we're happy to keep on answering. but I'll come on now to the commercial opportunities and sponsorship. So these awards have built over years into a central feature of business and civic life in each of the cities. We're focused on promoting events which create value. From thousands of companies, hundreds of nominations and dozens of sponsors, distinct value opportunities are created, and we'll be going through the benefits of the awards. The range of businesses involved and some of their reasons, with commercial options crafted for a variety of business sizes and budgets. So on sponsoring, partnering and attending, at the heart of the awards is a celebration of the cities, from the smallest of the indies to the largest of the corporates, rewarding business achievement and civic authenticity. The awards recognise excellence, the best businesses and organisations in the year. It's the most powerful positioning to align your brand with success in the context of high profile celebration. And there are multiple ways to engage with the awards commercially to fit all forms of business need and budget.
Yeah, think of it this way. It's not just effective, but it's efficient too. A single deal with one of our commercial team unlocks this huge amount of value. Plug in, go. Think of the effort it would take to generate this amount of activity, and that's social media and the marketing and all else that goes with it. But one deal goes. All that reach to key customers, those opportunities of connecting, all that time spent with them, time together. In some ways, that's the most underrated of all business KPIs. And imagine, as Steph has touched on, having the most prominence at the largest business event in each city where business is done. This form of social business is highly, highly effective way to generate new contacts, build relationships, create opportunities. And of course, it's backed, as we've taught, the extensive, effective, powerful marketing campaign. The other thing I think at a slightly deeper level is the mindset of everyone involved in these awards. It's highly positive. People are predisposed to be fans of the city, are wishing to get out there to connect, to generate business. And that is just the best possible backdrop to building relationships. Placing your brand and your people in such a positive, joyous environment can have limitless benefits.
So looking at our gold category offering, the gold star offering, the highest level of engagement with hundreds of companies with the awards. Deep association at all levels, from all the marketing to kinship with the credibility and values of the awards. The opportunity to choose the category that best fits strategically with your aims, maybe a particular category directly aligned to your business development. It might be legal, financial, business services, restaurant, whatever makes sense for your business. Or an area you wish to be associated with for brand benefits, such as charity, arts and creative, civic or sustainability. Or there's the new high profile employer category, which needs a sponsor. And you'll have a standout role on awards night, as well as having a prominently positioned table for your guests and team. We seek to work really closely with our gold sponsors in particular. So talk to us about the best ways to engage and generate value. And we'll have some testimonials shortly from a variety of sponsors. Next, it's the silver level. This is the secondary category with a dress table and marketing before, during and after the awards. It's a great chance to share good times with your clients in a sophisticated, celebratory, feel-good environment. Plus, there's marketing benefits involved with this package too. Limited release early bird silvers are now available on the website. Or for those of you watching on YouTube, they may have gone by now, so give us a shout if you're not sure. We've then got feature options, anything from sponsoring the shoulder events like the grand reveals and finalist receptions, to the cover stars, our special giant covers at the awards with a sponsor's logo. Posing is irresistible and the social activity is incredible around those. Or try this for inventive thinking. Lexus have had a special customized version of their cars at the Bristol and Cardiff Life Awards in previous years. One was the first tattooed car and the other car was designed by a local artist, and both received massive coverage via the awards. So we're always happy to work with you on your creative ideas that might enhance the awards and provide a great marketing opportunity. Then on to the tickets. Of course, there's the option to join in on the night with individual tickets, celebrate the city, build business contacts, join the exclusive pre-drinks and then after-show party, and you may even be one of the winners. So who are our sponsors? A highly diverse group with a different business needs to engage with the awards.
Yeah, I mean, just look at these. We'll have a quick whiz past some of these. It's great diversity. Some of them are nationals. You'll see the big names as we go through here, such as Thatcher's wanting to engage deeply in their cities and play their parts. You can see insurance companies, luxury car brands, top end real estate, international property. Others are regional or city, even city specific, connecting deeply, proud to be an Exeter, a Cardiff, a Bath or a Bristol based business, gaining value, standing out from immediate competitors. And others, as Steph has touched on, has had a particular offering that works closely with the awards, maybe hospitality venues, sports companies, multiple others. Yet more, some will be your peers, and think of it this way, others may even be your competitors. They have that limelight, might that be something you could consider? The other point is, so in comparison with almost any other form of media, there are only a finite number of sponsorships aiding that standout. When they're gone, they are gone. One last, there's value both directly from our marketing, but also the awards prestige. But the opportunity to create your own by leveraging a relationship with the awards. Please do talk to us about your ideas. Those sponsorships can be for 1, 2, 3 years. There's sliding discounts and all that good stuff. And thanks indeed to all our sponsors over the years and those to come. Thanks.
Absolutely. And this is what just a few of our sponsors say about why they support the awards and the benefits they gain. For some, it's about profile, others connection and partnerships, some wishing specific association with a category, others wanting to benefit from the full spread of marketing and association with the city's leading business activities, and others still wanting to demonstrate their support for and connection with the city to be a proud Bath, Bristol, Cardiff or Exeter company. That's especially true now, where veneration of local companies is a profound trend for businesses and consumers. Again, thank you to all.
Just before we come to the key dates, we're just going to check to see if there's some more questions.
Oh, yeah.
Do you accept video applications? If you wish to put them forward, do. Judges, if you can imagine, they've got a lot of reading to do and videos may be sort of less on their list. However, if companies are very, very sort of nip and tuck really close, it could be that video makes the difference. So please put it forward. I'd suggest if they're short, that's probably better. Thank you. That's from Sue again, Sue Serrett. From Alex Pilkington. Oh, well, very good. Alex, rather nicely saying it's been really useful and hope my cough clears. Me and you both, eh, Alex? All right. back to you, Steph.
Okay, so nominations. Here's some important dates for you. All of the nominations are open from next Monday in Bath, with Exeter, Cardiff and Bristol to follow soon. And they close. Bath is just a few days after we're back from Christmas break, so Monday, January the 15th. So please have a think about at least starting your nomination before Christmas. And then Exeter is 2 days later on January 17th, so same applies. Cardiff on January 24th and Bristol on January 31st. So definitely start thinking about those nominations now and making sure that you get them in by those various dates. Obviously, all those dates will be on the websites and we'll be sending lots of warnings via emails as well. It is based on the period covered of 2023, so there's no need to wait until the deadlines really to get started on your nomination now. On to grand reveals and receptions. How the process works is that we read through and discuss all of the nominations that come in and then shortlist only the best. We have several hundred entrants each year to the awards, so not all can make the shortlist. The finalists are those with the most credible chance of winning each category. And then we announce the finalists in one go, live on Zoom and on social media on these days, I'm going to say now, each at 2 p.m. And don't worry, all the dates are on the awards websites as well. So Bath will be January 18th, Bristol will be February 7th, Cardiff will be January 31st and Exeter will be January 24th. So please do register for the grand reveals as well when they come round and when you nominate, so you can save the date and you can watch live to see if you make it. We then hold exclusive receptions in real life for our finalists and sponsors on February the 8th in Bath, February 27th in Bristol, February 21st in Cardiff and February 14th in Exeter. And then of course, there are the awards nights. So definitely save these dates. Bath is February 29th, Bristol Life Awards on March 27th, Cardiff Life Awards on March 21st, and Exeter Living Awards on March the 7th. Four incredible awards nights in 5 weeks. We can't wait.
Well, just before we close off, we're just going to check so we've got yet more questions. I think we have more questions this time around, which is great, than ever previously. We will do pop anything through subsequently. I think we're out of time in other questions now. That's it for now. We're really, really proud of the support we've had for the awards and proud, too, of the opportunity they provide to help drive business in Bath, in Bristol, in Cardiff and in Exeter. When many, many, many hundreds of businesses come together and are promoted extensively, then value is created for us all. Here are the various Media Clash contacts with information also, of course, on the award sites. Thank you for considering the awards. We hope that you'd find us to be dynamic partners, helping you generate business and celebrate your excellence. Good luck with business in this coming year. This has been a Media Clash production. And this has been our very special How to Benefit from the Awards webinar. Thanks.
Thank you.